The last few months for Acura have been all about reminding us that they still like to build cars that go fast. We got behind the wheel of the TLX Type S, we saw the all-new NSX Type S, and they even showed us that the Integra will be making a comeback soon. Today, I'm here at the Grand Prix of Long Beach Race Circuit, not to talk about cars that go fast, but to talk about something that is still very important to the company's bottom line, and that is the RDX midsize crossover. They've given it a facelift for the 2022 model year, so stick around in this first look and we'll show you everything that's new. And before we get to talking about the new RDX, I'd love to remind you to please subscribe to the Moto One US channel. We have new videos going up every week and we won't want you to miss anything. Now bear with me for just a second because we're actually starting here on the NSX Type S. There's a reason for that. This is the first one we've seen from the factory in Long Beach Blue Pearl. And not only does it look fantastic, but if you follow me over here, it's the exact same paint that's on the new RDX. When I say that, only a few of them will be wearing this. This is called the PMC Edition, and they're limiting it just to 200 units. So they're gonna build this particular car in the exact same factory where they build this car over here. 200 units, and they're all going to be wearing this absolutely gorgeous shade of blue. So with only 200 of those PMC cars being built, you're not gonna see very many of these on the road. You'd be lucky if you did. Most of them will be A-spec cars, and those look slightly different, not only the color, but some of the trim pieces as well. So this exact car is slightly different, but for the most part, they're gonna carry the same general design motif. I have to say right off the bat, if you looked at this and said this is the same RDX that's been on the road for the last few years, I wouldn't blame you. There's not very many changes, but according to Acura, they did that on purpose because people are already pretty cool with the way it looked. In the face, there are a few things that are different. They've thinned out the trim piece that goes around the Pentagon grille here, and they've actually made some adjustments to the headlights. It's the same headlight as before, but beforehand there's a little bit more bright work and a few chrome trim pieces. On the A-spec and the PMC cars, they've darkened that out to kind of go with the black accessories on the rest of the car. Then down here, they've changed the front splitter just a bit and widened it across the front of the car to make it look a bit like the NSX, they say. I'll leave that one up to you. While we're treated to the sound of some loud race cars in the background, let's talk about the side profile of the 22 RDX and what's different. The wheels, that's gonna be the biggest tweak from here. New 19 and 20 inch wheel options. These are what Acura is saying is the top of the line. It's a 20 inch wheel, 15 spoke, and finished in black here. That's specific to the PMC car. The A-spec cars are going to wear the same wheel finished in a dark gray. With the black, I can see why they did it this way. The PMC is also gonna get you these black door handles and a black trim piece on top, but remember, that's gonna be a limited amount of cars, so get used to seeing these in body color and not as much black going on. The shape of the car as a whole, it looks the same as before, and I liked it before. The only part where you might lose me here is this floating C-pillar, but as we know, that's super trendy with midsize crossovers. And overall, the Acura RDX has always been a good-looking car with this generation, so I'm actually glad to see that they didn't tweak too much. Stop me if I've said this before, but things at the back of the car are pretty much the same as before. But it kind of makes me think, did they need to dramatically redesign the whole car, or put a really trendy taillight bar here? Is different necessarily better looking? Because the back of this car has always looked very clean. They've made a couple of subtle tweaks, and this is actually the second Acura to wear a black badge. That's crazy to me. The first car is the one over there, the NSX Type S. So they've expanded on the black pack with the PMC. You get all the black badging, but otherwise, it's gonna be the tailpipes that are just slightly different, and this new diffuser back here, finished in gloss black, that's specific to this car. Here in the cabin is where I'm gonna contradict myself a little bit, because it's here that I wish they did more. I gotta be honest about that. We've been in and around the new 22 MDX, and we've driven both cars. That car's infotainment setup is just more user-friendly. It's a slightly bigger screen, it's 12 and a half inches or so, and it's the first Acura to get an all-digital instrument cluster. The RDX retains its analog gauges from before. They really haven't changed much with how the user interacts. That's a miss for me. I think when you look at the class and the other cars that this car competes with, they could have done a bit more there. That said, they have tweaked a few things. On the tech front, this car now gets standard Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Both are going to be wireless for the first time. Additionally, they've added a wireless charging pad down below for your phone. That makes things a bit more modern. Otherwise, things are just going to be stylistic. I don't want to geek out on this for too long because again, this is just tied to the 200 PMC cars, but there's this really neat blue stitching that runs all the way around the cabin and it matches the exterior paint. The A-spec cars, which will be a lot more common, are still going to have this Alcantara trim piece. They're going to have this nice aluminum trim that's featured on the door panels. And now for the first time, you can get the A-spec package tied in with the advanced package. So what that basically does is it takes the most amount of tech, the most features you can get on the car, and it marries it with the A-spec style package. So for those customers that wanted both, now they can have both. The 2022 Acura RDX goes on sale later this year in November. We don't have an exact pricing confirmation yet, but you can expect it to be about the same as where it is now. So that means starting at under $40,000 by the time you add things like the A-spec and the advanced package, mid 40s and up from there. We also expect to drive this car in the coming weeks, so be sure to head over to MotorOne.com to get all the details.